Hi, I'm Dan Hill. I'm a lecturer for the University of Wisconsin-Whitewater College of Business and Economics. This is Marketing 312 Online Sales, Principles of Selling. And you know what, guys? It's going to be a fun course. It's immersive. It's experiential. You're going to get to do things. It's a doing course. Okay? You're not going to have any long, big, long papers. There'll be a couple little short things, just some write-ups and things you have to do, and weekly discussions and things like that. But a lot of it's going to be actually learning how to sell, learning some, doing some little role plays, and some simple recordings and a couple of simple phone calls and learning as you go. I don't expect you to be great when you start. And what's fun when I take this, when I do this course, is to watch people develop over the course and watch them. And all of a sudden, 6 weeks later, they feel pretty confident in what they're doing and they're actually pretty good at it. And I hear from almost every single person that takes a course how much they've learned and how they're going to be able to use what they learned in their future careers, even if they're not going to be in sales. So let's get right into what I call this syllabus lecture, which is all about the syllabus and what we're going to have to go through. So a couple things. To get a hold of me, the best thing you can do is email me, okay? I watch and monitor my emails all the time, so I don't really have set hours. I did my MBA online. I was 38 years in sales and sales and sales management, and I did my MBA online so I could come teach after I retired here at UW-Whitewater. So I was 58 years old when I crossed that stage with my MBA, and all but one class was online. I realized what you're doing, taking classes online. Most of you are non-traditional students. You have jobs, you have families, you have other obligations, and the reason you do an online class isn't because it's easier, it's actually a little harder. The reason you do an online class is because you can work on it when you need to. So if it's 2 o'clock in the morning, whatever, you know, you can do it, okay? So I get that. So I do have my email, I monitor it real regularly and I watch it. The other thing I put right here, I didn't even put my office number for you. I put my cell phone because right now with COVID, I'm not in the office anyway. You can text me. I'd appreciate if you'd use the order first, email me, text me. And then if you really, really need me, it's really important, give me a call. I understand. I remember getting callbacks on Sundays from a couple instructors and wasn't really expecting it. So, but, you know, just make sure when you text, identify who you are. So that I know who it is, and because I won't have you in my contact. So please do that. If you really need to talk, and I've been there where there's a real issue and you got to get it taken care of, or you're really concerned, call me. Otherwise, a text will usually get it done. An email will certainly get it done. Okay. Our book is Selling, Building Partnerships by Castleberry Turner and some others. And it's a great book, 10th edition, and you get it from the textbook rental. So make sure you order it from them and get it from them. Okay. That's really important. Everything else is online. You're really probably not going to have any other materials at a marginal cost. The only thing that you may have to do is buy yourself a camcorder, not a camcorder, a webcam. And microphone if you don't have one, but most devices today have them built in. The only thing is sometimes the microphones aren't the best. Quite often I've used a headset, or people now are using the AirPods, which are really, really effective. They sound great. We are going to break this course into modules. I'll talk a little bit about that. The prerequisites, of course, you have to be of junior standing. And this is a requirement for marketing class, and for good reason, because these are the skills you're going to use. You're all going to end up with a degree, and most of you will end up in some sort of a supervisory situation. And if nothing else, you're going to have, whether you're doing marketing research or digital marketing, you're going to have to sell your ideas to other people, okay? And where a lot of people fall down is how to sell those ideas, how to present those ideas. So that's what we're working on. We're working on presentation and selling and the steps of a sale and how you go about it, all right? So, obviously the objective of the course is we're going to do a lot about ethics and the sales function. So you understand every organization has a sales function, by the way. There has to be some way that you complete that transaction. Even if you're a nonprofit, you still have to bring in money somehow, some way. It may be in the form of fundraising. That's sales, by the way. Okay. And then you will understand the buying process, how people make decisions, okay, how they buy in. When you are managing people, when you are trying to persuade somebody to do something, selling isn't telling. Selling is getting them to buy in, to do something that's in their best interest. And that's important. And then you're going to have to know and understand the steps of the sales process. And that's where we're going to do some role playing and have a good time. Okay. And it will be fun. We will communicate electronically, and I really expect you to check in daily with your emails. I'm going to use the email on uww.edu. I don't care if you have Gmail or something else. That's where we're going to communicate, is uww.edu, and there's a lot of good reasons for that, that we're doing it. You can have that set up to monitor on your cell phone. You can have it so it's monitored through Gmail, whatever, but everything's going to come through uww.edu, and that's where it has to come from me as well. I'm also going to post class announcements, so make sure you have subscribed to class announcements. And there's going to be something in class called Raise Your Hand. It's a discussion forum. Subscribe to that too. Because a lot of people will ask questions that don't necessarily pertain to or that pertain to the course, and but aren't personal. You know, like, hey, I can't find where the instructions for this assignment are. You may be having the same question when you get to it, so subscribe to it. Save yourself a lot of time, or you'll see somebody else ask a question that you already know the answer, and you can share back. I try to get back to those as quick as possible. But a lot of times, other students beat me to it, and it saves everyone a lot of time. Okay, academic dishonesty goes without saying. I think we all know about that. Exams and quizzes, let's talk about that. There will not be a final exam, but there will be quizzes. And these weekly quizzes are given each of the first 5 weeks. And on those five quizzes, each quiz counts for two chapters of the text. Now, do you have to read every word of that text? No. I have posted lectures for you, and those lectures cover the material that, by and large, most of it's in the text, okay, that I think is important for you to know. I'm not one of those professors who says, boy, you need to know every word that's in that text. There's more there than you need to know on just how to sell. A lot of it's advanced things that you don't need, things that you learn, different companies do different. Right now, what I'm going to teach you is principles of selling. It's the basics. It's the fundamentals. So take a look at those lectures. There are PowerPoints on a lot of those lectures. They're also posted in the Canvas. And you can look at that, what the subject matter is. That's going to tell you what those quizzes are. The quizzes, by the way, are open book. But they are not, they're open book and they're open notes, but they are not open internet. Okay? So I'm going to ask that you stick to that and please respect that. Don't go on this and search the answers. Yeah, you can search answers for quiz answers. You're not going to learn anything. Here's what I'm doing instead. Five quizzes, and you take the five quizzes, and each quiz you can take two times. And we're going to keep your highest score of the two times. Okay, so you should do pretty well. There's the last quiz for the 6 week is optional. It is not required. So you can take that quiz, and it will replace your lowest score of the other five. So, or if you miss a quiz, quizzes aren't made up because you know, you always have the opportunity to get that sixth one in. The sixth one will be more of a comprehensive quiz. It'll have all the other chapters plus the last two chapters that are in the book that we assign. And I don't assign all the chapters because you only have 6 weeks. So again, I'm picking out the things that I think are most important for you to learn. Okay. Respondus monitor, I talked about. One of the things I was going to mention, so you're not going to need the Respondus monitor. You will need the Respondus lockdown browser, but there is a test, a quiz that you should take right away to make sure your technology is working. And so that one does require the monitor on it, but you're going to need a webcam anyway for the exercises that we're going to do. So make sure that your device has a webcam, a working camera, whatever you're using. Some people use their cell phones. Some people use their laptop with the webcam in the cover of the laptop. Some people, like I have a monitor with my webcam sitting on top and a microphone there. So just make sure that you're going to have good sound, that we can hear you, and that that we're going to be able to see you, because that's going to be important, okay? But you really won't need to take the test except for that one first little quiz that Respondus requires that you test all three, or the internet lockdown browser and the webcam. Participation. This is an online class. It is asynchronous, meaning that you can schedule your time. That's why I put weekly modules, okay? However, in a classroom, there is always a lot of give and take, a lot of information, a lot of sharing of ideas and experiences and exercises. And that is what we are going to do here. So we have a discussion module, and you can go into assignments, and there's discussions and exercises, discussion slash exercises, and it lists them out by week. And some weeks there's two assignments. Some weeks it's a discussion, some weeks it's an exercise, and some weeks it's both. This is a big part of your class. It's 150 points, I believe, so that's 15% of the class. Please take the time to do it. It enriches the experience. You will learn a lot. And not only that, but it's simple. It doesn't take that long to do. But these are all valuable things that will help you, and you will learn a lot from it. And the things you'll learn in this will help you to be better in the bigger assignments. In every case, the discussion period and the exercise period begins on the prior Sunday and ends on the following Sunday. I give you an extra day in there to make sure that you can get the discussions done, because in most discussions, you're going to have to go in twice. You'll have to do something in the first half of the week, and then the second half of the week, you'll have to do something else. Okay? So again, this is like being in class, and if you're not present in class, you miss out on a big part of it. So this is really, really important, and it's not hard to do, and it's big points, okay? A lot of them, by the way, the modules, the weekly modules, are going to begin on Monday and end on the following Sunday, except for, of course, the first one, which will begin on Tuesday after Labor Day, although we have this open on Friday. And it will end on, the last week ends on July 3rd, which is a Friday. So that gives you 4th of July weekend, but means it cuts your module week short, okay? For the discussions, part A is done in the first half of the week. Part B is done in the second half of the week. There will be some times I'm going to have you do answer some Dan probes. In all cases, you're going to have to comment on other students' comments. So in the first half of the week, you're going to put some sort of thread, or you're going to do a video. You're going to do something that you're going to post. And then the other students and yourself in the second half of the week will be commenting on your classmates' posts and what they had to say. And a comment is not, yeah, me too, I think so too. No, it has to have some meat to it to count. Basically, I count your participation more than I do the quality, other than the, yeah, me too, doesn't, you know, the one or two sentence reply doesn't count, okay? So make sure that you put a meaningful post that people can read and they'll get something out of. We have what we call competition role plays. These are sales competitions that we run. The actual company that's going to be doing this is still to be determined, although I'm meeting with somebody tomorrow that I've already talked to that have given us a preliminary go ahead, but I'm not going to say the name until we know for sure. But what we do is we actually set up sales competition role plays, and we do these versus via WebEx. WebEx is the virtual tool that we use. We don't use Zoom. We don't use Microsoft Teams. We use WebEx or WebEx Teams to complete these competitions. And in most cases, you'll either be submitting a recording for judgment, or you will be actually doing a role play with a representative from that company. We'll give you a scenario. We'll give you information about the company. Hopefully, we'll even be able to provide some examples of how this works so you have an idea what it looks like. Hopefully we will. And then you're able to actually try it yourself, practice it a little bit, and then you will do the scenario live. Now, I've so far scheduled those times, and they're in the syllabus, and there's three major competitions. One is a phone call, where you make a call and get a quick appointment. The second one is going to be you're going to call back and you're going to do a needs identification where you're going to find out what their needs are and some issues and get an appointment to move it to the next step where you're actually going to do a presentation. The third one for sure is going to be virtual WebEx. You'll be face to face with them and it's going to be a team sell. So you'll have a partner with you from the class. And that week before, you're going to have to pick a partner. And hopefully by then you get to know from the discussions and everything else who the other people are, and you'll get a feel for who you want to partner up with. And on all of these, they're going to run on Wednesday, probably starting around 3:30 in the afternoon and run into the evenings, which will give most people an opportunity to participate. Now, I'm going to say right now, if for some reason you absolutely cannot participate, if there is a problem, communication's key. Talk to me. We have some different tools and things we can use to help work around some of those things and make some accommodations. But in most cases, people are able to find a way to participate, and we're hoping that'll work. But give you an example. Last summer, I had a gal who was a very, very sharp lady, by the way, who was an airline attendant. And she goes out to the airport, sits there, and waits on call. And sometimes she doesn't get a trip, so she's just sitting there in the lounge using the computer and can do everything. And other times, 15 minutes before she has to get on the airplane, she's being told, "You got to go." And one time, right before a competition, she called me and said, "I got to go. I got to fly to Atlanta." I said, "Fine, and we worked out something later on for her to do. So, all reasonable accommodations to be made, but you need to communicate, okay? Writing skills, there is a video in there called Writing Tips, and please use good professional writing skills. Grading, there's 1,000 points to this, and these are all the assignments. There's a thing in here called Challis Assessment I'll have you take, which teaches you what kind of a sales job you'd be a good fit for, but also gives a great report back what your strengths are, what your weaknesses are. And it's a real good personal assessment for anyone to have. There's a salesperson interview. You're going to have to find somebody to interview. You can do it over the phone, but you have to find somebody who's in sales to interview. And I've got a list of questions for you. There's a perfect pitch where you are going to actually take one of our sponsoring companies, and you're going to have to look them up, find out what they are looking for in a salesperson, what kind of characteristics they look for, and then you have to give basically a 40-second to 90-second pitch. You just met that person, and you have to tell them why they should be interested in hiring you and ask for an interview or the next step. You're going to have to leave a voicemail to a potential customer. You're going to have to, at some point, record an impactful story. And it can be a very personal story, but it's going to be an impactful story. So we're going to learn a little bit the art of storytelling. We're going to have the competition, the role play, the making the appointment I mentioned before, the building rapport, and the needs ID phone call where you come back and you find out what's important to them. And then the team selling, we actually present what you're going to sell and you try to close on the sale and get a contract. There's the quizzes, the participation discussions. I'm sorry, this is 100 and oh, maybe it is 120 points. Okay, I'll double check that. And then at the end, there's a course climate evaluation, which is sent out at the end of every semester. And I'm given points for you filling that out. I feel that feedback is very important, and we appreciate you doing that. So this is the syllabus. This is what it looks like. And you can see here we got the list of the chapters for each week. So each week one starts on May 26th, day after Memorial Day. And these are the things. We have a week one discussion, and then there's an introduce yourself to the class video exercise where you have to create a brief video and tell the class about yourself. We will have, by the way, in the first week, a course introduction. I'm going to set up two WebEx times, one on Thursday night and one on Friday morning. So whenever you're available, you can get on this WebEx and we'll go through a little bit of this and explain some of the course and answer your questions. If for some reason you cannot, let me know and we'll work out something else and I'll get you the information you need to know. Okay? But this is a great chance to get to know the others and also test out the gear and make sure everything is working well and just like say answer the questions. The second week, again, we've got two things. We have the buying process discussion, and then we have the perfect pitch exercise. Then there's the leave the voicemail assignment and the perfect pitch recording, which at the end of the week you will submit. The perfect pitch exercise, I'll get into more detail, but basically is you will do a perfect pitch, and then all your partners, all the classmates will leave messages saying, hey, this is what we think you did well. This is what we think you could improve upon. At the end of the week, you can re-record it if you wish to get a better grade and then submit it for grading. Okay. The Challenge assessment will be due the 24th, and so I put things that are going to be due coming up. And then you have to reserve time for the appointment setting, sales call, role play. So we'll send out a link. Watch your email. And the class announcements. We'll send out a link where you can go in and you can actually set a time, pick a time when you can do that phone call. And it goes on each week. Week three discussion. We'll talk about how you approach, make an approach to somebody, and then there's appointment setting, sales calls that week. And then we have the building rapport week four. Week five, we don't have that. We just have some of the assignments are due, and you can prepare for that final one with your teammate whom you've selected that week. Okay. At the end, the last week, we have the competition role play on July 1st. And again, that'll probably be from about 3:30 to, maybe 7 or so at night. And then the quiz six, which is optional. So I went a little lighter on that week, just doing the role play, so you can prepare for it, get ready, and you can do that quiz if you need to, and then the course is done. So thanks a lot for listening. Sorry this takes so long, but it's important information, and I do try to keep the other recordings much shorter. Thank you.